Hello, my name is Jorinde van der Vis. I'm a postdoc at DAISY in Hamburg, and I'm going to tell you about a simple way of estimating the gravitational wave signal from a first-order cosmological phase transition in any model of new physics. And such a gravitational wave signal could potentially be observed by LISA. So why do we care about cosmological first-order phase transitions? Well, they would be a sign of new physics. The standard model of particle physics does not predict any first-order phase transition, so observing such a signal would definitely point at the existence of new physics. We are particularly interested in this kind of new physics because it might be related to the generation of the baryon asymmetry. One of the conditions for the generation of a matter-antimatter asymmetry is the existence of out-of-equilibrium dynamics, of which a first-order phase transition is an example. So how does one get a first-order phase transition? Well, this depends on the finite temperature effective potential of your scalar field. So let's look at this scalar field phi. You can think of it as the Higgs field, but it could also be another field. And at large temperature, its potential looks like this. It has a minimum only at a field value of zero. Now, as the temperature lowers, a second minimum develops. And as the temperature becomes lower and lower, this minimum actually becomes energetically favorable. A phase transition is first order if there is a bump between the two minima. And then the field tunnels from the true vacuum, or from the false vacuum, excuse me, to the true vacuum. And this proceeds by the formation of bubbles. So let us think about the electroweak phase transition for now. So if this would be a first order phase transition, then bubbles form, in which the Higgs has obtained its non-zero vacuum expectation value and the standard model particles have become massive. And these bubbles expand and collide. And in this process, a gravitational wave signal could be formed. And this would lead to a stochastic background of gravitational waves. Now, how do we predict such a gravitational wave signal? It turns out from lattice simulations that they can actually be described, the spectrum, by a rather simple formula. So this is a formula for a spectrum, and it's given in terms of these four quantities. The first one is the Hubble parameter at nucleation, and the second, the mean bubble separation. And for both of these quantities, one needs the particle physics at finite temperature analysis. So this is done to, for example, obtain a nucleation temperature. Another parameter that goes into the mean bubble separation is the bubble wall velocity. And this will be used as an external parameter in my talk. It's actually quite involved to determine the bubble wall velocity, and it also depends on the model. Then we have the function C, which determines the shape of the spectrum, and it depends on k, the momentum, and again on the mean bubble separation. And then here we have quantity A, and A contains the input from the lattice in these two numbers, but also k squared. And k is the kinetic energy fraction, and this is what we are after in this talk. The kinetic energy fraction is given by the kinetic energy density in the fluid divided by the energy density at the nucleation temperature, right before nucleation. And one determines the kinetic energy fraction by solving the hydrodynamic equations of a single expanding bubble in a plasma. K depends on the phase transition strength and also on the speed of sound in the plasma. And it depends on the bubble wall velocity, which is, as I said, treated as an external parameter. Now, the goal of our work was to determine the kinetic energy fraction as a function of the phase transition strength, the wall velocity, and the speed of sound, without further model dependence. In this way, our result can be used for any beyond the standard model physics. So we want our result to be reusable, without the need for other people to solve the hydrodynamic equations as well. So let's have a look at these hydrodynamic equations. So the plasma is described by a perfect fluid. So this is the energy momentum tensor of the perfect fluid in terms of the enthalpy, W, It's for momentum, U, the pressure, P, and the metric, G. The hydrodynamic equations are simply follow from the continuity equations given here. And then by integrating over small area around the bubble wall, one gets a set of matching equations. So V plus and V minus are the fluid velocity right in front and right behind the bubble wall. And the matching equations are given in terms of the pressure and the energy density before, in front of and behind the bubble wall. Now, when one solves these hydrodynamic equations, one can get three types of solutions. For very fast bubble walls, one gets a detonation. In this case, the bubble expands faster than the speed of sound, and the plasma is at rest in front of the bubble wall, and then behind the bubble wall, there's a reflection wave. For slow bubble walls, one gets a deflagration. In this case, there's a shock front in front of the bubble wall, and the plasma is at rest inside of the bubble. And then there's a hybrid for intermediate wall velocities, and the hybrid has a reflection wave as well as a shock in front. So here we have an example of a solution of the hydrodynamic equations. On the left, we have the velocity profile. Xi is the coordinate perpendicular to the bubble wall, and V is the velocity profile of the plasma. It's a hybrid, so this here is the position of the bubble wall, and in front we have shock, and behind we have a reflection wave. And on the right we get the enthalpy and entropy profiles, and knowing the equation of state, one can convert the enthalpy profile into a temperature profile as well. Now, this set of equations was solved already in 2010 for the so-called Bag equation of state. And the Bag equation of state is assumes that in the symmetric phase and in the broken phase, we have relativistic particles. And the difference between the energy difference between the two phases is given by the Bag constant, epsilon. And this Bag constant is independent of the temperature. And this leads to a constant speed of sound, 1 over square root 3. Now, remember that we are looking for the kinetic energy fraction. And this kinetic energy fraction can be determined from the parameter kappa, which is closely related to the kinetic energy fraction. It's the kinetic energy in the plasma divided by the Bag constant. And this kappa here is only dependent on the wall velocity, Vw, and alpha, the phase transition strength. And this alpha is given by the Bag constant divided by the enthalpy. So this paper obtained a fit for kappa in terms of alpha and the wall speed. And this fit can be used for generalization to other models. So in that case, one simply computes the phase transition strength and uses the fit for the Bag equation of state to get the kinetic energy fraction. But how should one actually do this? It's not so trivial how to compute the strength of the phase transition in a different model. And where is actually the sound speed dependence? So in the literature, one typically finds a couple of ways to generalize this approach. Please note that only the nucleation temperature is known from if one does not solve the hydrodynamic equations, at least. So one should define these alphas in terms of the nucleation temperature. So one often sees in the literature alpha defined in terms of the pressure difference or the energy difference, or in terms of the difference of the trace of the energy momentum tensor. Note that there's a suspicious thing about the first two definitions, because if one plugs in the Bag equation of state into these two definitions, one does not even get the same value of alpha as one does here. This is not the case for the third definition in terms of the trace. But note that in all three cases, the speed of sound never enters, whereas in a general beyond the standard model physics model, the speed of sound is not 1/√3 as it is in the back model. Okay, so we want to go slightly beyond this approach. So let us first see where the hydrodynamics equations are dependent on the model. This here is the set of hydrodynamic equations for the coordinates xi, the fluid velocity, and the enthalpy. And you can see that the model dependence actually only enters through the sound speed, Cs. But also it enters in the matching conditions, through the energy density and the pressure. Now we made the following assumption. We assumed that the temperature in front of and behind the wall are very close to each other. And then we can make a Taylor expansion. We also assume that the speed of sound is constant in the symmetric phase and also in the broken phase. So we have two different constant values for the speed of sound. Now under this assumption, the matching can actually be expressed in terms of the speed of sound and a new phase transition strength. And this new phase transition strength is in terms of what we call the pseudo-trace, and the pseudo-trace depends on the speed of sound. Now the relation between the velocity in front of and behind the wall is completely determined by our new phase transition strength, the sound speed, and the speed of the wall. And because the hydrodynamics only depend on the sound, or only depend on the model for the sound speed, also this kappa here depends only on these three parameters. So kappa now has become model independent, and k, the kinetic energy fraction, can easily be obtained from there by plugging in the equation of state. Okay, so now we introduce a generalization of the back model, which does depend on the sound speed, and this will be used later to find a model-independent fit. So this generalization of the speed of sound we call the new mu model, and it looks very similar to the back model, but note that instead of a 4, we have a mu and a nu here. And these nus are mu's are given in terms of the speed of sound in the broken and in the symmetric phase, respectively. So the new method that we propose is the following. One can map their model of new physics onto a new mu model with the same phase transition strength, speeds of sound in the symmetric and in the broken phase. And then we have provided a code snippet with which one can simply compute the value of kappa, and kappa can then be translated into the kinetic energy fraction. So this code snippet is provided in our paper here. So far only for detonations, but the result for hybrids and deflagrations is underway. So we compare our new method to other methods that have been used in literature. But of course, as a benchmark, we have to solve the full hydrodynamic equations without making any assumptions. So this we call method one. Then method two is our new approach. So we map our model of new physics onto the new mu model. And then we compare to the other four methods that we know from the literature. And all these four methods rely on mapping onto the back equation of state. So the speed of sound never enters. The two toy models that we consider are standard model-like, although we have to make the Higgs mass very light, otherwise we would not get a first order phase transition. So it's not exactly the standard model. And a two-step phase transition. And then in this table we list the relevant parameters. And note that here I only show the result for detonations. The deflagrations and hybrids show qualitatively similar results. So we compare our five methods to the exact result, method one, and we see that our proposed method, mapping onto the new mu model, gives usually sub-percent accuracy. So it really outperforms all the four other methods. Then note that of the methods known in the literature, method five and method six are based on the energy and pressure difference, and they perform particularly poorly. So if you only want to map onto the bag equation of state, then it's better to use the trace. But it's even better, of course, to use our new method, which also includes the effect of the sound speed. So that brings me to my summary. Gravitational waves are a promising tool to test the physics beyond the standard model in the presence of a first order phase transition. One can describe the hydrodynamics in an almost model-independent way in terms of our new phase transition strength, the sound speed, and the bubble wall velocity. And by matching a model of new physics onto the new mu model, one can accurately determine the kinetic energy fraction with the help of our code snippet that was provided in our paper. Thank you very much.